Now we have a little bit better lighting and stuff. I was kind of mad about the lighting, but this is yoga. We need dim lights. We need calming lights. We need nice, relaxing stuff going on. And here's Weston to wish y'all a nice, relaxing week because he just loves to cuddle and stuff. So he loves to relax too. So here's Weston, you know, trying to relax with us, I guess. I don't know. Can you please go? Go. With the starting poses, okay, this one's gonna be kind of challenging, but our first pose, we're gonna make it a standing one. You should be able to see me. I'm trying to get it to where it's not like the other video where you couldn't see me, but we're gonna go down. We're gonna put our hands behind our backs like this. We're gonna bend over and try to, yeah, you can bend your legs slightly. But I say try to, you know, straighten them out as much as you can. And breathe. We're gonna hold these for 30 seconds each. I'm gonna call the swan because it looks like a swan. So we're gonna lay down, and it's gonna be like the other one where you reach back, but you're also gonna have your feet up. Now we're gonna do one that's kind of stretching, and this is gonna be two parts, but it's gonna be one move. So if you've ever done gymnastics and stuff, you're gonna stretch like this. I'm gonna try and get it where you can see. Move. So you're just gonna try to keep your hips forward. And if you have bad knees like me, you need a lot of padding so you don't hurt your knees. You're gonna try to keep your hips forward and straight and just sit in this. This is gonna really stretch and elongate the muscles, and it's gonna release a lot of things. I don't know how the technical term, but stretching releases a lot of stuff from your muscles, which enables your muscles to be elongated, which gives off a more lean look. Other side. You're gonna sit in there, hips straight and forward. You don't want to put one lower than the other. You want to have them straight. And you want your knee and your feet, or your knee and your ankle, to be aligned. Plank position, but instead of you having your four, whatever, like this, you're gonna have your palms down to the ground and try to straighten it out. You don't want to round your back or do this. You want to try to keep your back straight for this part. So we're gonna have our hands hands down flat. You're going to try to have your back straight. And halfway there. The only time we're going to do that. You want to try to get ready as if you're about to do a squat, but instead of doing a squat, we're going to stay right here and we're going to stay in this position for 30 seconds. You want to make sure you're out, okay? Halfway there. It's almost like a reverse plank, I like to call it. You're gonna have both hands like this, facing towards your feet, and you're gonna, I believe, yes, you're gonna have your feet like this. You don't want them pointed, you want them flexed. And we're gonna lean up. It's a little bit easier when you have your feet pointed. Try to push your hips up. Almost there. Okay. And this one. Your feet out like this. And your hands are going to be forward. So if you don't have your balance, at least try to keep your feet behind you and keep your balance with your arms. Don't try to use anything. You want to really try to keep your flat and your leg back. You want to try to get your arms in front of you. But again, if you don't have balance, try the best you can. Even I don't have balance, as you can see. But it does still help trying to keep that up. Okay. Now the other side, I'm going to try to use this right here. Try to keep it straight. Almost there. Four, three, two, one. Okay. This one's gonna be a standing up one. I'm trying to get it back as far as possible so y'all can see. You're gonna take your leg. Gonna tuck it right here. I don't think it would help more if I didn't have these on. You want to tuck it right in there in your inner thigh and do this. You really want to work on having this down here and this more up, but since we are beginning and we are amateurs at this, we're just gonna do this. If you're not that flexible, you can do this. Try to keep that leg up. Oh. Almost there. switch on the other side, just so we keep everything even. As you can see, my right side is more dominant, so it's easier. We're gonna do one. This one apparently targets the core. So we're gonna reach, stand up, and we're gonna try to lock your hands like this and try to lean back as much as you can and breathe. Have it come up every now and then because I don't want y'all breaking y'all's backs because this feels like it hurts a lot. Hold this there. Six, five, four, three, one. Okay. Had to breathe. Okay, since the other one was a back bending one, I don't want y'all to have y'all's backs hurting, but we're going to get down on this level and we are going to basically, I forgot what this one's called, but everybody knows this one. You're going to like kind of do this and then lean back. Make sure you have that nice stretch and try to get your all the way down to your ankles. So you're gonna try to achieve that nice stretch and stuff. This is apparently a pose that will help with weight loss, and it also helps with stretching and all that. So, hopefully nobody hurt themselves on those. I'm getting these straight from Pinterest, and these moves seem like they're super duper hard. So if y'all broke y'all's backs or whatever, I'm so sorry. I'm trying to try new yoga poses and stuff without having to take the actual yoga classes because yoga classes are expensive and I'm a stay-at-home dog mom, so I don't have time to go out for an hour or two just to do yoga poses because I need to sit here and take care of the dogs. So hopefully you stay-at-home moms also learn and got to enjoy this and everything. So far with these yoga poses, I think I lost a lot of water weight. I weighed myself in this morning and I was like 3 to 4 pounds. I want to say I started off weighing around 150 with this and now I'm like 147, 146. So hopefully that y'all get to lose some water weight too. And hopefully we get to tone up more rather than lose weight. I'm not saying we're going to lose 50 pounds with this. Maybe you enjoy yoga poses and you actually see a really big change in your body. That's great. That's why I'm doing this, to see if I see a change in my body and to see if I rather do yoga than actual workouts, because I used to lift weights all the time and do a whole bunch of weightlifting and stuff, and that puts a lot of strain on my knees. So I'm trying to find alternative workouts. Join me for tomorrow. I think I'm just going to do this until Thursday. So Wednesday and Thursday, two more days. I said this was going to be a week. I'm going to make this into 4 episodes. So, yeah. Thank you for joining me, and have a nice day.